I'm starting this project off with this pizza pan that I got from Dollar Tree. And using Waverly chalk paint in the color ink, I'm just focusing on putting that paint along the edges of the pizza pan. I didn't do the middle section because I'm going to fill that up later with something else. Once that is complete, you just want to allow that to completely dry before moving on. I then got this scrapbook paper from Hobby Lobby. And I'm using the sticker that was on the pizza pan as a template to get the correct size on that scrapbook paper so it will fit perfectly inside of that pizza pan. Once that was traced out, I just cut that scrapbook paper right down to size. And then to be able to adhere the scrapbook paper onto the pizza pan, I'm using some Mod Podge. You want to just put a generous but even amount of Mod Podge onto the pizza pan. Once it was evenly distributed, I just placed that scrapbook paper right on top of the Mod Podge, smoothed it out with my fingers until there was no air bubbles. Allow that to completely dry, and then to seal and protect the scrapbook paper, I just went over it with another coat of Mod Podge. And then put that pizza pan aside to allow it to completely dry. I got this black foam board from Dollar Tree, and I made a template cutout, which if you want to create this project yourself, I did upload the template on the description above. So all I did was just trace out that template right onto the foam board. And once that was all traced out, just use a box cutter to carefully cut that tracing right out. And you just want to make sure that you have a really nice sharp pair of box cutters before doing this step. Again, I cannot stress this enough. Please be careful when using box cutters. Once I had those all cut out, I wanted to cover up the white foam along the sides of the foam board. So I just went back in with that Waverly chalk paint in the color ink, and I just covered up that white. And I also used the chalk paint just all throughout the foam board just so it matches up perfectly. So now for the cutouts that look like these little hearts, I am tracing those on the back of some black and white Buffalo check scrapbook paper. Once those were all traced out, I just cut those right out. And again, to be able to adhere the scrapbook paper right onto the foam, I just used some Mod Podge. Once the Mod Podge was evenly distributed, I just placed that scrapbook paper right on top and just smoothed it out with my hands. And if you have some excess scrapbook paper along the edges, you could just use a sanding block just to sand those edges right off, and that leaves you with a nice smooth finish. And look at how cute these came out. So now for the tear-shaped cut out, I'm just using some masking tape. And for this step, there is no right or wrong way to put these down. Wherever you want to place them is completely up to you. Once those were put down, I'm using Waverly chalk paint in the color Maze. You could also use any yellow acrylic paint. You want to allow that to completely dry and then go ahead and just pull that masking tape right up. So now let's go back to that pizza pan. Now that it is completely dry, I'm just using some nautical rope and I'm just hot gluing that nautical rope all along the inside edge of the pizza pan. And you just want to do this until that is completely filled in. I like doing this just because it covers up the cut edge of that scrapbook paper. Now let's assemble this all together. So the heart shape, I am just hot gluing those to the sides of the pizza pan. Once those were both put down, I then just used the teardrop shape with the stripes painted on it, and I just hot glued that right into the center of the pizza pan. And then the black circle that I cut out, I just placed that right underneath the teardrop shape. And look at how cute that is. You just created an adorable bumblebee. So now to create some antennas for the bumblebee, I just cut up some pipe cleaner. I just cut that right up in half. And then I just gave the top of them a little swirl and just hot glued those at the top of the bumblebee's head. And I cannot get over how adorable this is. So now just to add some accent pieces to the top of the pizza pan, I just made this bow. I just hot glued it right at the top of the pizza pan. And then I got these sunflowers from Hobby Lobby. I just hot glued those right behind the bow that I created. And there you go, guys. I hope you enjoyed watching this as much as I enjoyed creating it. I hope this inspired you to create your own. If it did, please be sure to sprinkle the love. Thank you so, so much. And I hope you all have a good rest of your day. Thanks. Bye.